Okay, in case if anybody missed, you can just execute this program because I could not see the output of this. Nobody has sent. Okay, and also 8A simple calculator. So yesterday I was explaining the calculator, but I have not shown the output. Today I will show the output. Okay. Okay, for this, whenever you are doing the sixth program, that is if you want to keep track of number of visitors visiting the web page, okay, and the corresponding information, how many number of visitors visited, that information you will be storing in a text file in the same root directory. Okay, so from there you are going to read and you are going to display. Okay, for that this is a code we have already discussed yesterday. Let me just go to the output. You can see maybe because of previous value, it was 6. When I refresh this, I got 7. Okay. Next time, if you refresh, you can just see. So each time when I refresh, it indicates that the first, like it is loading the page once again. Newly, it is loading the page. That's why. So it will be keep on incrementing. The same thing, it will be updating in that. Counter.txt. Yesterday I have shown where you have to create how the value is going to update. Okay, this is about the finding the number of visitors visited the web page. Okay, using PHP code. See the code, if you already know the logic, okay, how it can be performed, only the syntax you need to follow with respect to PHP. It is not a complex program. And when you are doing your projects, no, you can just add this part. Okay, so this concept you can add it. Okay, at the footer part, you can just add how many number of visitors visited. You just try to add all these concepts, whatever you are learning in the theory part. Okay, so yesterday I was explaining about this 8 program. I'm just going randomly with respect to the lab programs because whichever it is relevant to. PHP, I'm just doing that. Okay, so there are some more programs with respect to JavaScript, still it is left out. I will cover later. So let me, because you are in track now with respect to PHP, that's why I'm just picked this program. Okay, so here there is a PHP program. What exactly it is going to do? So the first one is to create the simple calculator. I did not find anybody put the snapshot with respect to calculator. Okay, so few students have put the snapshot with respect to matrix multiplication. Oh, so that I have not yet explained. So let me just, I think the program I have already explained with respect to the calculator. Okay, so where you need to display the output in the form of table. Okay, so accordingly you can just give the a style for the table. So your main focus is how exactly it is going to make use of the form data that is submitted by the user and calculate the arithmetic operations. So here in the JavaScript, what we did, like reading two numbers from the user and perform a particular operation. Okay, so here when you click on calculate or submit, so it will perform calculation of all the operations. Okay, so however you want, you can write the code. So this is the table heading you should get, that is simple calculator. So followed by you'll be having two input box. Okay, input that is of type text. This is one and another is this one. Okay, you have to give the proper naming num1 and num2 because you are going to make use of these names, name values for the calculation. Okay, so to read the value that is entered by the user in the text box. Okay, that is done. And the form method, this is also very very important. If you are using get, you can just go with the get or post, but you should be knowing when to use get and post. Okay, because you already know what are the advantage and disadvantage or the difference between get and post. Accordingly you need to use the proper method in the form. Okay, so that completes the form. Go to PHP part. So now what you have to do is in PHP part, you need to read these two values that is entered by the, just entered by the user. Okay, so where those values are stored, how you can read. So because here I specified the method, form method is post, so you have to use the corresponding super global array to access that. So now before going further, first always make habit of doing some validation. Okay, so is set, so it checks the input submit is filled or not before whenever you click on a submit button. Before performing the corresponding operation, first it has to check is it the fields are filled. Okay, if it is true, then it will go to the next line. Otherwise, okay, you will be getting an echo message. Okay, echo message that is written in the JavaScript. You can just see once if you are know the technology, you should be flexible to use any of these things, either stylish CSS or JavaScript. Okay, according to the requirement, you should be able to embed the code in the program. So you will be getting an alert message. So enter a valid number. Okay, in case if it is not valid. So let me just go to that program. So that is ATA. So I am just checking I have given proper values or not, input. Okay, so I'll just go with empty. Let me see what I'll get. Can you see? I am getting an alert message. So this is how you should be flexible in making use of the concept whatever you learned. Okay, so enter a valid number. Okay, so that is one condition you need to check. Let me just go further. Consider if you have filled the fields and if you are clicking on submit or calculate, before performing the arithmetic operation, it has to check is the value centered, is it number or a string. Okay, because you are performing the arithmetic operation, obviously it should be number. So you can just observe. So if this condition is true, it will get into the loop. So here what you are doing, you are trying to fetch the value that is entered by the user, okay, with the help of dollar post, and store that into a temporary variable called dollar num1. Okay, and the second variable is dollar num2 to store the second number. Once it is done, now you can make use of these variables to perform the operation, and also you can use it for checking the condition. So what is this condition I am checking here before performing the arithmetic operation? I need to ensure that the value entered or it should be numeric. Okay, for that there is a predefined function is numeric. Okay, is numeric dollar num1 and is numeric dollar num2. That means it should satisfy both the condition. Okay, both the numbers should be numeric. If these two conditions are satisfied, then it will get into the next line. Okay, it will get into the next line. What you are doing in the next line? Okay, here you are going to perform the additions, all the arithmetic operation. Okay, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay, so because you are displaying the output in the form of table, okay, accordingly you need to use this table structure. Okay, so you can just observe. So addition of two numbers, directly it is written here. It is not like that store sum is equal to num1, that is also fine. You can directly specify, it will save the time. Okay, so and this is subtraction. So dot, this is concatenation operator, dollar num1 into dollar num2. Okay, that is multiplication and this is division. Okay, so it's very simple, but you should be very thorough with the syntax. So let me just, one condition I have checked, that is where I have entered, submitted the form without any fields. That's why I'm getting this error message. Okay, so whenever you are implementing any program, always try to adopt all possible conditions to be checked. Okay, so next what I do is I'll just try to enter ABC 123. Okay, now I want to perform arithmetic operation. I know this the first input is not correct, but your program should able to tell that. Okay, can you see I am getting the error, enter valid number. Okay, it is an alert message to the user. You need to give the proper value. Okay, let me just give. Okay, so for this also I am getting error. Actually, I should get alert message. Okay, because I have given string, that's why it is not accepting. That's why I'm getting fatal error. So let me just go back and give the proper input. Okay. So now if I click on calculate, first it will check these conditions. Okay, so according to my input, this condition is satisfied, this condition is also satisfied, then it will perform all these operations. Arithmetic operations. Okay, click on calculate. You can just observe. Okay, addition of 10 plus 5, 15, subtraction 5, multiplication 10 into 5, then division. 10 divided by 5, it is 2. Okay, I think many of you have already done using JavaScript. Okay, nicely, if you student, they have enhanced the program. And they have written very well in the JavaScript. Similarly, you do this program also. There is nothing much difference. If you are for this program, you should have the knowledge concept of JavaScript. Okay, first table format. You should be knowing the table format. How to use table tag in HTML. Okay, so accordingly, you will come to know that how to use column span, row span, all those things. I'm not going to repeat all those things, because you already familiar with those things. Okay, if anybody is still having confusion with column span, row span, just try to do the basic program first. Okay, then it requires CSS concept. Then here I have used even JavaScript. Okay, so the JavaScript, this one. Okay. Then to perform the actual logic, I will use the PHP. You can just see the PHP code. Okay. So when the student, if you are able to execute this, so it tells that at least you have the knowledge of all these things. Okay, so now maximum we have covered all this part, except PHP still I have a lot of concept to cover, but to do the basic operations, you can just start with those concept. Okay, you can just complete this program, very simple program. Any queries with respect to this program? That is the first one, simple calculator. I'm not going to give any specific condition with respect to how you need to design, okay, what should be the color. That is all left to you. Okay, how attractively you can design the web page, you can design it. Only thing is, for me, you have to use the PHP code. Okay, so PHP code, and also you should have include all possible error conditions. Okay, any queries? Okay, so good. At least parallelly you are all sitting in the along with your laptop, you can just try the program. Okay, Chandan has completed the sixth program. Because later means I don't think so you people will execute. So I'll just finish one more very small program with respect to matrix. Then I'll allow you people to execute it. Okay, parallelly you can just, who are not having system facility, you can just write down others. I think online compiler is there, no? You can just make use of that online compiler. Online compiler. Okay. I need to check it. That code.pen, I think it is not going to support PHP. I need to check that. I think here you can just go till JavaScript, that's all. PHP cannot be embedded here. Okay, PHP cannot be done, only static pages you can do it. So there is one more online compiler. Python.io. Okay, so whenever if you are working, I think you are using for other laboratory, you will be familiar with this online editor. Okay, so PHP programs you can just do it in Python.io. If that is the case, it does not require to install Xamth. Okay, who are having the laptop, you can just go ahead with the Xamth. Okay, this is for the students who are not having the facility of laptop. If it is not there, try to buy the laptop, because you have a lot of I think this semester mini projects and all those things. This year you will be getting a lot of advertisers. Okay, so this is my program. Hopefully it is visible. Okay, you just run. You can see the output. Okay. So you can just make use of this, because the code pen.io, here there is no PHP option. Okay, only HTML, CSS, JavaScript, till that it is fine. So when you want to do this PHP program execution, just you make use of this Python.io. Okay. Okay, so that's all about the 8th program. So next we'll move on to the second part of the 8th program. So there, where you are going to work with a matrix. Okay, so there are two more sub questions with respect to 8th program. Am I audible? No, am I audible? Can someone respond?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Thank you. So write a PHP program to do the following. Okay, so here this program is like a static once again. Static in the sense the code is not written for reading the array values directly from the user. Okay. So here I have already taken predefined array values. For that, I am applying three operations. One is transpose. I want to change the matrix to transpose matrix, then multiplication matrix, then addition of two matrix. Okay. So these are the three operations I need to perform on two arrays. Okay, sorry, on two matrix. So matrix are represented using arrays in two dimensional. Okay. Okay, good. At least a few students are doing parallelly. See, understand the program. So at least this shows that you people are working seriously. Okay, who are not sending the snapshot, So I don't think so. You people are involved. Will you people want to execute this and later go for the next one, or shall I explain the first, the remaining part of the co-program? How you want? Okay, so that's the case. Let me just complete this transpose matrix. Okay, so this is once again using PHP program. So you can directly start with a PHP code. So here I am creating a temporary array, that is a variable $a. Okay, it is two dimensional array. You can just observe how two dimensional array is mentioned. Okay, so this is 3x3 matrix. I have taken 3x3 matrix, and you should be knowing so what are the conditions you need to check for addition of two matrix and also multiplication of true matrix. Okay, you normally, I think you people already know the how to perform the multiplication of two matrix, addition of two matrix. Maybe you have done in C program, and also some other language if you have learned Python or any other languages. Okay, so the same concept is used here. So I am creating an array, so where the first row contains value 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Okay, this is how you are going to represent the 3x3 matrix in PHP. Okay, next, this is the second matrix. Later what you have to do is, after execution of this program, you do some small changes in this program. So instead of creating static or the predefined values, okay, not runtime values you are taking here. Okay, so now you change this program later after execution. So where you should read the data from user. Okay, so when you run your program, it should read the data from user. Okay, you have to change the program to perform like that. So this is the second matrix. Okay, so now what I am doing is, I am just finding the length of the, or number of elements that is present in the array. Okay, so you already know, I think many of you have answered the different types of functions supported by PHP with respect to array. Many of you use this function count, so that is going to give the number of elements. Okay, so now $a indicates the first, it is going to point to the first row of the matrix. Okay, and the value, how many elements are there here? It is 3. So that value, it is stored into $m. Okay, you already know when you are working with the matrix. So the first matrix, it is represented with m cross n. Okay, the second matrix, it is represented with p cross q. Okay, it is just for your convenience. Normally we'll use these terms m into n and p into q. You can use any variable. Okay, similarly, to fetch the second row elements. Okay, so you have to specify the index value for that. It is 2. Okay, similarly, go with the p and q. This is to find the number of elements that is present, size of matrix. So using count, you can just fetch it. Next, what I am doing is, here I am trying to display the first matrix value. Okay, so you know already how it can be done. Because it is two dimensional, you will be having two for loops. Okay, so row is equal to 0, row is less than or equal to m. Okay, row plus plus, then followed by another for loop with respect to column. Okay, so it's very similar to the previous whatever you learned. Just try to display what is the first row of element of information. You are just displaying the elements one by one. So rows, initially you will be getting the index a of 0, okay, column 0. Okay, that means you will be getting the first element. So let me just write the matrix what we have here. The first matrix, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, and the second matrix is 7, 8, 9, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so according to this, I am telling. So, A of 0, what you are going to get with respect to this is first matrix. A of 0, 0. So that means it will display the first number. Okay, that is 1. Similarly, so this loop, it is going to execute as long as this condition is true. Okay, so from this for loop, you will be able to read the first complete first row. Okay, for reading second row, then this condition, it is going to fail. You will come out of the for loop and it will go back to this loop. It will check the condition. If it is true, it will try to fetch the second row values. Okay, so like this for loop, it is going to execute till it reads all the values and display it. Here I'm just echoing. Okay, echoing after each, once this condition is failed, there will be a break, line break. Similarly, you can just try to do with the second matrix. Okay, so for second matrix, we have used the term P and Q. Accordingly, you can just specify the condition and display the second matrix. So what is transpose matrix? Can somebody tell what is the meaning of transpose matrix? Maybe in your data structure, I think you have done this program. What do you mean by transpose matrix? Someone quickly answer.
Turning rows into columns and columns to rows.
Yes. Yes, little bit louder.
Turning all the rows to columns and columns to rows.
Okay. You are just interchanging the rows and columns. That's all. Very simple. So accordingly, you just write the for loop. Okay. Here I am doing for the first matrix. So the transpose of this is for the first matrix, where you are interchanging the rows and columns. So before, what was the rows and columns for? So here 1, 2, 3. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. You will be, this row is changed to column. After execution of this program, you will be getting like this. Okay. So this is called as transpose matrix. Similarly, it works for the second matrix. You can just see, I'm just interchanging the column and row. Okay, so only this is a logic. So normally it is row and column. You are just interchanging each element. You're just interchanging. So that is row into column. So similarly, you can just go ahead with the second matrix. Next, we'll move on to addition of two matrix. Okay, so whenever if you want to add two matrix, it has to satisfy the condition. That is, M is equal to P and N is equal to Q. What is M and N? So M cross N is the size of the first matrix, and P cross Q is the size of the second matrix. So whenever if you want to add two matrix, so that is number of rows should match with the second matrix. Number of rows from the first matrix and second matrix should match. Even number of columns also should match. Then only you can perform the addition of two matrix. If any one condition is failed, you cannot perform the addition of matrix. Okay. Okay, you can just observe here. So take one element from the each matrix. Okay, first matrix, add with the second matrix. So B indicates the second matrix. This is the first matrix. I'm not going in detail like how to add to matrix. I am just focusing on the PHP part, because this is commonly executed program in other languages. Okay, this is a condition you need to write. Similarly, for multiplication, what is the condition should be satisfied? So for multiplication, so that is number of columns should be equal to number of rows of second matrix. Okay, then only you can perform the multiplication. Okay, so according to our input, it is 3×3. Okay, so where n is 3 and p is 3, condition is satisfied. Okay, then it will go for further operation of multiplication. Okay, so this is the main logic. Till here, I think everybody knows. Okay, and this is, you will be having 3 for loop for performing the multiplication. In case if you don't know, just trace the program. Okay, trace the program, consider I is equal to 0 first time, then j is 0, k is 0 accordingly. So what is the value you are going to get here? Okay, you just try to trace the program, then you will understand. Okay, so I'm not going to do the tracing part here, so that is left to you people. Okay, once multiplication it is done, so what you are going to do, so you're going to just display the result using the follow. Okay, so here what is the important thing is the conditions. So you should give the proper conditions, then only you will get the correct result. Okay, so if you don't know any of these things, you have to trace it, then only you will understand. Without tracing, you may not understand. So let me just run this program. Okay, here it is not going to ask any input, so directly you will be getting the output. Okay, you can just observe. Any queries? If you have any queries, you can ask. Just check it, is it got the correct answer or not? See here, I have not done any background color or font, some changes, because the main concentration here it is for the PHP code. If you want, you can apply all the styles if it requires. You can just put each of the output in the form of table, that is also okay.